Good morning, students. In last video, we discussed about how to balance a chemical equation. Now, and one more point also we discussed, after balancing a chemical equation, how to make it more informative by using the symbols of gases, liquids, if any precipitate is evolved, if any precipitate is formed, we can represent by the down arrow. If any gases are present, we can represent with the up arrow. Like this, all the points we discussed. Now, in this video, I am going to explain what information we can interpret or you can explain through a balanced chemical equation. Let us see. Here I took an example. When sodium reacts with water, it produces sodium hydroxide and water. From this equation, what are the information you can get or you can explain? That we will discuss in this video. See, first, in this equation is balanced or not, first we have to check it. Here sodium is 1, here sodium is 2. So you must balance it with the 2. See, I explained about the step wise, but sometimes you can write it, no problem. Depends on the marks, you have to elaborate the answer. Now, 2 sodiums and here oxygen also, 2 oxygen, here 1 oxygen, so you must write it as 2. Then once you check hydrogen, here 2 and you do 4, here 2 to the 4. So the given equation is balanced. After balancing the chemical equation, we will discuss now point wise. The first point is, from a balanced chemical equation, it gives the information about R and P ion. Here R for reactants and P for products. So a balanced chemical equation gives the information of reactants and products through their symbols and formula. So here arrow before what are the substances that are present, that we know, that we'll call it as reactants. And after the arrow, the head of the arrow, the right side, we'll call it as products. So here the reactants work you can find out through symbols and their formulas. Sodium, here I'm writing the reactants. In this balanced chemical equation, what are the reactants? Sodium and water means H2. Now coming to the products. What are the products? Sodium hydroxide, NaOH, hydrogen gas. So this, next coming to the second point. What is the next point? It gives the ratio of molecules of reactants and the products. From a balanced chemical equation, you can get the ratio of what is the ratio of the reactants and what is the ratio of the molecules of products. Here, when you are taking 2 molecules of sodium, it reacts with the 2 molecules of water. Means the ratio is, in the reactant side is 2:2. Next, coming to the products side, the ratio of the molecules, means sodium hydroxide is working this, the 2 molecules of this react with 1 molecule. So in the product side is 2:1. Like that you can get the information, you can explain. Now coming to the third point. As molecular masses are expressed in unified mass, the relative masses of the reactants and the products are known from the equation. See, in this balanced chemical equation, each molecule or the compound's atomic mass you can find out. Already in the 9th class, you have one chapter, then how to calculate the masses and what is mole, what is Avogadro number, related you have one topic. Already you learned in 9th class, the same topic, that knowledge you must apply to understand these points. Okay, now, here the sodium is there. So first find out what is the mass of sodium. Then next find out what is the mass of water molecule. So reactants you find out. Next you find out the mass of sodium hydroxide and then water. So once again to understand, here I am writing the balanced equation for this point. and 2H2O gives rise to 2NaOH plus H2. You know that the atomic mass of sodium is 23. So 2 into 23 plus 2 into hydrogen, atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. So here two hydrogens are there, so you must write it as 2 into 1, or if you are getting confused, so here you write, find out what term. See, 2 into 1 plus oxygen, atomic mass of oxygen is 16. Then you will get 2 plus 16, total 18. The atomic mass of water is 18, gives rise to, then 2 into atomic mass of sodium is 23. Plus oxygen is 16. Plus hydrogen 1 plus 2 into 1. Like that you can calculate and simplify. Here 2 into 23 you will get it as 46 plus 32, 36 gives rise to 23 plus 16, 39 plus 7, 40, 40 into 2 is 18 plus 2. Now, here you got the mass of sodium, mass of water, mass of sodium hydroxide and mass of hydrogen gas. So, the mass, if you are calculating in terms of the unified mass, you must represent the letter as U. U represents unified, you are measuring the mass in terms of unified mass. So you must write it as 46 unified mass of sodium react with the 36 unified mass of water gives rise to 80 unified mass of sodium hydroxide. Then 2 unified mass of water. Like this you can calculate the mass of reactants and the products from a balanced chemical equation in terms of unified mass. Now coming to the fourth point, the same mass if you are calculating in terms of grams, the same mass, the reactants mass and the products mass, if you are calculating in terms of grams, instead of U, you must write it as Z. See here, if the masses are expressed in grams, the equation also gives the molar ratios of reactants and products. Here, instead of this, you must write it as 46 grams of sodium react with the 36 grams of water gives rise to 80 grams of sodium hydroxide plus 2 grams of hydrogen gas. Like that, depends on the unit, you must write it. Understand? Now coming to the fifth point. When you are before going to explain this fifth point, first you must understand the mole concept. You must understand the mole concept. What is mole? For example, your mother said to bring some grocery items from the shop. You are asking that person, you are bringing, for example, 1 kg of salt, next, and 1 liter of oil, and 1 dozen of fruits. Suppose your mother said to bring those three items. Okay. So here, kg, liter, dozen. Here for each substance, the units are different. Why we are not using the same unit for all? Suppose if you want to measure the distance, you are using either meters, kilometers, centimeters, like that. You are not using that kg or liters or something. So here, depends on the things or the objects, we have to take the units are different. See, suppose you will not ask that grocery person, that shopman, please give me 1 kg of oil. Will you ask like that? No. For liquids and gases, the mass we will calculate in terms of volumes. In terms of volumes. So coming to the chemistry, we are using a word to measure the
liquids and gases we are using, a unit is mole. Unit is mole. Mole means, suppose if you take one molecule, if you are taken one molecule and you are finding the mass of that one molecule in grams. Once again I am repeating, mole means you are finding the mass of any substance, any molecule, that is only one molecule. You have to take one molecule of any substance, any item, and that you are calculating the mass in terms of grams. For example, I will take water. Here one molecule of water. Here one molecule of water is there. So you are calculating the mass here. Already you got it. The mass of water is how much? Here two molecules means you got as 36. But one molecule of water is how much? 18. So that you are getting 18 grams. So that 18 grams is equals to the one mole. Is equals to the one mole. Suppose if you want sodium chloride. If you want sodium chloride, NaCl, sodium is 23 and that chlorine is 35.5. Then how much you will get? 58.5 grams. So that masses, when you are measuring in grams, when you are taken one molecule, that we will call it, short form is GMM, gram molecular mass. Gram molecular mass, that is known as one mole. Understand? Now coming to the next point. This mole, if gases are evolved, we can equate their masses to their volumes and calculate the volume. See, masses means you can calculate in grams. Suppose any gases are evolved, that we cannot ask. Suppose I gave an example that please give me 1 kg of oil or 1 kg of milk. Will you ask? Will you use? No. Like that, to find out the gases, mass of the gases, we have to use the term as volume. So here in the reactants, if any in the reactants here, you are taken as that mass in terms of mass. The reactants that you are expressing the weight in grams, but the same in the products side, if you get any gases, that gases mass you will not calculate in grams, that always you must find out in terms of volumes. Understand? In terms of volume. How to find out? For example, if you are taken your sodium, I'll take the example of your sodium. What is the mass of sodium? Here we got it as 46. When you are taken 46 grams of sodium, you are getting how many grams of hydrogen? 2 grams of hydrogen. You are getting 2 grams of hydrogen. This hydrogen is a gas, so you should not calculate in terms of gram. You must change that one into the liters, volume. So here, any gas at STP, what is meant by STP? STP is nothing but standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature and pressure. At this condition, any gas, it occupies a volume of 22.4 liters. It occupies 22.4 liters. For example, if I take the 2 grams of hydrogen at STP, your temperature is 0 degrees or otherwise 273 degrees Kelvin. You can take either centigrade means 0, Kelvin means 273.
And the atmospheric pressure is 1 or otherwise 76 centimeters or otherwise 760 milliliters.
They are the standard units of temperature and pressure. Now coming to,
if you are taking 2 grams of hydrogen at STP, it occupies a volume of 22.4 liters. How much? 22.4 liters. So like that, the mass you must change into the volumes. Here you see, if the gases are evolved, we can equate their masses to their volumes and calculate the volume.
In problems, you will get more information, detail I will explain. Now coming to the last point.
Using molar mass and Avogadro's number, we can calculate the number of molecules and atoms of different substances from the equation.
If you know 1 mole of any substance, for example, here,
your place is not sufficient on the basis. You got it as you are supposed. If I take 1 mole of hydrogen gas, here 1 mole means 1 molecule.
1 molecule of mass in terms of grams, 1 mole.
So here I am taking hydrogen, 1 molecule. Okay, if I take 2H2, means here I am taking 2 moles of hydrogen, means 2 molecules of hydrogen gas.
So understand the difference clearly.
Here suppose if I take 1 mole of hydrogen, you know that how to, that mass you must change into, how to change into the volume. Means 2 grams of hydrogen, it occupies at STP is 22.4 liters.
Any gas at STP it occupies.
For example, if you take nitrogen,
if you take nitrogen, what is the atomic mass of nitrogen is 40.
Next, or otherwise
7.
Nitrogen is 7. 7 into 2, you will get 14 grams. So this N2 also at STP, it occupies
2.4 liters. If you take oxygen, oxygen atomic mass is 16. So O2 means 16 plus 16, 32.
So 32 grams of O2 at STP, it occupies 2.4 liters.
Like this, any gas, at 1 mole of any gas, it occupies, the volume is same, that you know.
Now, coming to, then, suppose if you take 1 mole of any substance,
1 mole of any substance, for example,
if I take here H2, for example, NaOH, or you can take it as HCl.
You can take any substance, but that should be 1 mole. And it contains
how many number of molecules? For example,
this I will explain through one exam. Everyone, you know, suppose 1 kg of salt. 1 kg of salt means you will get this big packet. 1 kg is equals to, in that how many crystals of salt are there? That everyone, you know, so many. Suppose, if I ask you 1 mole of sugar, sorry, 1 mole of salt.
Here 1 mole of salt means sodium is 23, chlorine is 35.5. Then it is equals to 58.5 grams.
Suppose if you have taken 1 mole of salt, you will get
58.5 grams of salt.
58 grams means maybe it is equals to half of the spoon.
The quantity which is equals to half of the spoon.
So in that half of the spoon, can you calculate how many number of that crystals, salt crystals are there? No, it is not possible because they are very minute like that. In the chemistry, the atoms and the molecules are also very minute. It is very difficult to calculate the number. So that's why when you find any one mole of any substance, it contains the number, either the atoms or the molecules or the ions, the number is same. That is how much that one? It is equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23. If you want to find out the atoms, if you want to find out the molecule, 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. If you want ions, so if you take any one mole of substance that you can find out, change into the volume, the same mole you can change into the number of atoms or the molecules. So this number, we'll call it as Avogadro number. We'll call it as Avogadro number. So Avogadro number, it is represented as NA, number of molecules or atoms. Here A for Avogadro number. So instead of this, they will represent with N. Okay. Suppose you here you are finding here one mole of hydrogen gas. Suppose if I want to find out 2 moles of hydrogen gas, then I must represent it with 2NA. 2NA means 2 molecules of Avogadro number. So one molecule means it has this. Suppose if you take any substance, either H2, N2, HCl, H2S44, KCl, KOH, COOH, twice, any substance, one molecule, it contains the number of particles in that, either the atoms or the molecules or ions, that number is same. That is this one, that we call it as Avogadro number. Understand? If you want to take a calculate from the 2 molecules, 3 molecules, 4 molecules, you must write before that Avogadro number, you must represent. Suppose if you want to find out the how many number of molecules are there in the 5 molecules of hydrogen, means you want to write it as 5 molecules of hydrogen, then you must write it as 5 into Avogadro number. Understand? Okay. Now from all these points, one more point is the last point. Here, using the molar mass means by using the mass of the substances, you can find out the mass in grams, and you can find out in that particular one molecule of the substance how many number of molecules are there, and what is the volume of that substance, like that relations you can calculate. And from all this, you can find out, from a balanced chemical equation, you can find out mass-mass relationship, means between the reactants and the products, you can calculate mass-mass relationship and mass-volume relationship, volume-volume relationship, and the last one is mass, volume and Avogadro number or number of molecules relationship. Like this, you can find out, you can get the information through a balanced chemical equation. Now, based on this, we have 3 problems which are given in the textbook. Now, I will explain, and this is important question for more 4 marks. Last 2-3 years back, they asked this question for 4 marks. So, understand it. Thank you.